Now, we're in the editor mode. Actually, it just looks the same as normal, but you don't have the background animation and music, and you can't change the settings. To show up the editor menu, just press the spacebar. A menu at the top will appear. It contains all the needed tools that you will need to create your own maps. First, we will import the map preview image. So we choose Import Texture from the Tools menu and select the files that we want to import. I'm not going to tell you what all these settings do. I will create a separate tutorial for texture importing, which covers most of the settings. For now, just check the following settings. Texture type, rect, alpha channel. If your TGA file contains an alpha channel, set this to transparency, otherwise you can skip it. Use S3TC compression. And finally, flip image vertically. Now press the import button and you're done. If you want to know if it succeeded, you can open the command console. Go to Tools and Command Console. And now here it is, import the texture. Just to see the editor, you can now open the map in it. Choose Tools, Open World, or press Ctrl and O and select the Word file. How to use the editor is part of later tutorials, where I'm going to explain you how you can import art from Macs, how you set the materials and stuff like that. So now let's just test the map. Close the editor and the command console, go to host local game, select our new map at a few bots. And just press start. Now, that's it. Just watch the bots. The bluish net is part of the debugging process for the bot navigation. I will show you later how you can disable this. For now, just ignore it. Okay, now everything works as expected. Let's go back to the main menu. The final step is to pack the level, so that you can share it with other people and play it normally, without the editor mode. Once again, we need the command console. In it, just type pack tutorial 01. This will pack all the files in the tutorial01 directory. That's all we can do in the editor mode now. Back to Windows. This is the last part of this tutorial. We go into the data directory and you will see a new created file called tutorial01.pack. This file was created when we used the pack command. It stores all the files from the tutorial01 directory. First, let's have a look at the Word file directory. It now contains the tutorial_level01.txt file, the preview image of the level, which we just imported. Now the final step. If you want to use the new custom map normally without starting the game in the editor mode, you will have to copy the tutorial.pack file over to the maps directory. If you leave it in the data directory, it won't show up in the game. This is for security reasons. Now, the map is ready to use. You can share the pack file with other people and play it with bots or against other players. Now that's it. The first tutorial is over. Thanks for your attention. I hope you liked it.